Good day, fellas. This is your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to publish the lucky winners, which you can see right here. Kyler will do some kind of magic. At the time when I'm recording this video, there was 9,000 comments, so chance to win is 1 out of 900. So for lucky people which is going to win this, fellas, can we have a big fact rigged in the chat? Because those guys, they was obviously pre-selected before. Obviously, I'm joking with you, I'm missing. But I would appreciate a big fat rigged in the chat. So thank you so much for that. I want to see the full comment section of this. And obviously, congratulations to the lucky winners. How everything is going to look like, you are going to get the prizes in your account more likely in the next week or this week. I'm not entirely sure. I will provide the names of yours to Wargaming, and Wargaming is going to give the prizes, right? Once again, if you are wondering what this giveaway is for and what happened and so on, so it's very simple situation, fellas. We was part of the event where we needed to mark Polish medium tanks. We marked all Polish happen. Anyways, what is today's plan, fellas? I decided to play with Object 140. I want to test this vehicle out. I can't remember when last time I played with it. Actually, that was 4 months ago on the YouTube, so why not to play it once again? And there is some news which is coming in with this vehicle. If I'm not mistaken, Wargaming is planning to move this vehicle, because why the heck not, fellas? So yeah, quite interesting situation, but as you can see, it is how it is. No complaints, no regrets. And without further ado, I believe we can go into the battle. We are going to play a couple of battles. Obviously, our main plan is going to be to get from 4,500 to 5,000. I hope everything will go well, but we'll see. You know, knowing the matchmaking, sometimes the things can be rough. But I must admit one thing. As you can see over there, we have mines winning spawn. And speaking, what do we have here, fellas? That's very, very, very good thing. All we need to do right here, we need to probably try to take the hill. Actually, there is two options how we could play this battle. We could try to go on top. There is no Artis. You know what? Plan B. Skill, what do you mean plan B? How dare you? The thing is, I will try to risk it for the biscuit. What that means? That means either it's going to be very, very good, or either you are not going to see this YouTube video. As simple as this. Now jokes aside, I can go on top of the hill. I'm very, very well aware of that, but I want to cross like this, like immediately. Why so? Because there is literally no artist which could punish me for doing like, for going over there, right? And I believe, fellas, we can simply deal with every single mother trucker which is playing around this area. Simple as this. This is the plan for us, boys and girls, ladies and gents. And as you can see, our Projetos is making a hardcore pressure too. And oh boy, I can promise you one very, very important thing. All enemy team is doomed over there. Why am I saying so? Why they are doomed? The thing is, people which is playing around this area, they are going to have such a horrible time right here. It is bloody insane. As an example, this Leo, he thinks he is safe. No, you are not safe, buddy. That's it. GG, finito. Enemies lost this battle already because our team was playing way more aggressive than obviously enemy team was. We have the hill, we have the middle, and enemies can go and eat a kaku. So this is one of the strategies how you can play this battle. With all respect, boys, I would highly I would highly recommend to try to cross to this small island over there and simply bang everyone what you are seeing in your way, because that can work extremely well, as you can see that yourself. Now, speaking about extremely well, there is a CDC which I knew he is over there, and obviously we are using our magic, which means we are going to blind fire this guy just in the face, and Mr. CDC is dead. He cannot do anything. He can only dream about his lucky, happy place. But, you know, in the end of the day, he's dead meat. Now, the next step, which what do we want to do now? We want to keep making pressure idea. I see, Progetto. Progetto is raising his PP and he's going together with us, which is completely fine. And we are just making a massive, I repeat, massive pressure over there, and we are destroying everyone what is in our way. This is what we want to see, and this is how we are doing the things, right? Progetto just took one for the team, so I assume Char Futur is here. Fellas, my blind shots are top notch, okay? My blind shots are so damn good, it's crazy how good they are. It is crazy, fellas. It is crazy. Skill, have you ever heard the words humble? Absolutely, yes. I am the most humble person in the world. Now, with all respect, jokes aside, this battle is very, very good what we are doing right here. We are punishing enemies for every single tiniest mistake which they are doing here, but there is not too much things to be proud of, because we are having a better spawn than enemy does in the mines, right? And we are simply banging them. We are not even asking their name, we are just showing the dominance towards them. Simple as this. They are getting shitter spawn, they are losing battle, end of the story. I wish to say they could and they have a chance to do something over there. No, they don't. With all respect, fellas, no, they don't. They can do whatever flying F they want, but they are in such a deep kaku hole. It is bloody insane. And with all respect, how many fires? How many blind shots? What the flying F is happening in this battle, with all respect, my friends? What the flying F is happening in this battle? I am playing like a king. But Skill, you are Baboon King. Thank you. I almost forgot that. Thanks. Thanks for reminding me this, fellas. I almost forgot that. So look at this. That was a massive dominance. That was ideal battle. It was risked for the biscuit strategy to cross here, but in those 4 minutes of this battle, right, we pretty much did everything properly. Our gun is as heated as a bloody hot potato, okay? We cannot even touch it. We need to drop it like this, if that makes sense, right? So once again, epic battle. We did everything properly. We showed the dominance on the mine. Solid 7,000 damage, 1,000 assisting damage. Pay attention at the how long this battle was. 4 minutes 13 seconds, fellas. Blind shots, RNG, everything was just in our favor. Such a beautiful tank. By the way, fellas, 140 definitely deserves to get buffed, because in my opinion, this is quite a sad tank. It's quite bad tank. Do you agree, fellas? I mean, 1-to-1, come on. 140 is the tank which deserves it to get buffed. Now, I believe you can sense the sarcasm from my side. Skill, in your opinion, do you think 140 needs to get buffed? Absolutely not. This vehicle is good as it is, and this is definitely not the tank which is, you know, crying in the corner and saying, please buff me. It's just not the case, boys and girls, ladies and gents. It is just not the case. Anyways, what do we want to do now? I believe, fellas, there is a couple of options what we can do. We can either go into the city, or we can either go on the field. And you know what? Let's do an unusual thing. Let's go on the field. I am not doing this too often, because I know this can be a big pain in the ass strategy, right? Especially when you are getting stuck over there and you are getting banged by the Artas. But you know what? Why not to be a bit risky here? Why not to show enemies dominance once again? And by the looks of it, at least from the start of this day, of this session, it might be my day and we might have a very, very, very great time. That was quite a horrible aim by me. Not much what I can do about this. Luckily, I'm not getting spotted. And speaking about this STB one, this STB is sitting in the deep shithole of over there, right? Now look, this STB, we cannot do too much for him, although he's sitting quiet, his position is not very, very good. But there is other things which I really want to do, fellas. I really want to bang the progetto until it's too late, right? Where do we need to aim? We need to aim into the turret. Don't try to shoot the upper hull with this tank for obvious reasons, right? It's just simply not worth it. Speaking about the things which is not worth it, to get hit by the two artists, obviously it's always painful and it's always not nice, but with all respect, fellas, I would love to say I could dodge this, but I couldn't. Artists decided to go for me instead of going for the standard B or E50M, so not much what we can change right here. We are the chosen ones, fellas. So at least that's something, right? Okay, look. What is the plan now? Now we need to go through the middle like this and we need to spot the guys which is sitting in the base. This is the plan. So without further ado, without thinking too much, I am just making a bloody hardcore pressure, okay? Like, as hard as I can go, just to get as much assisting damage as physically and as physically possible, right? Because I assume they should have a couple of the medium tanks which is sitting in the back over there, right? At least that's what I assume. He's dead, fellas. With all respect, this guy, he is dead. At least he should be dead, right? He's thinking about killing me and obviously he picked up the kill. Oh my bananas, that was quite sad. Okay, anyways, what happened over there? Knowing how many guns we had in this area for this guy to survive from 6 to 7 seconds, that was quite sad, don't you think so? But unfortunately, things happened like this and our pigeons did not manage to hit him immediately. That's okay, it happens. 1.2 thousand damage, 1.2 thousand assisting damage. Once again, quite shitty ass game. How did we lost majority of our hit points? Let's speak about it. Minus 400, minus 500, minus 400. So what do we have? We have minus 1.3000 damage from the artists. In other words, stop cry kid and stop camping, you know? What we can do about this? Literally nothing. So we are teleporting into the other battle and let's hope we are going to have just tiny touch better gaming experience, right? From the battle in mines to this is quite a big downgrade, don't you think so? And we are back. As you can see, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we did not manage to win this battle. By the looks of it, I made a mistake by going super aggressively, but you know, it happens. Enemies did a very great job. They cleared the city, they came back, they cleared remaining forces over there. That was a flawless performance from the enemy side, and I simply was way too aggressive towards the enemy forces right here. I must admit it, mistakes is happening. I was on the wave, you know, when we had a very, very good performance, and now I simply took one for the team. Oh well, what can we do? No complaints, no regrets, accept it, move on. Next battle, the third battle with 140. Come on, can we get something better? Oh, sure we can. Shitfield with the three artists. Thank you so much, I appreciate it. In my opinion, I said that many, many times before, this is one of the worst artists for any class apart art. Why so? It's just how it is. At least that's what I think about this. It is, you cannot pretty much be art safe wherever. If you are trying to play the game, you are going to get banged by the artist, right? That's the main point, that's the main thing which I want to say, and there is pretty much no safe spots, especially if artists are smart. By saying smart, if there is three artists, one art over there, one art over there, one art over there, that's it. They are covering pretty much every single point of the map, and then you are having a massive troubles because you are getting bombed by the everywhere. But once again, it is how it is. We are not going to cry. We are going to try to deal with this situation ourselves, and our goal is to get like 5 grand combined. This is going to be the ultimate score, but I really, really, really doubt we are going to deal with this. But we'll see. We'll see. We are not giving up yet, right? That shot which I shot towards the EBR, it wasn't the best one, obviously. I was a bit late with my reaction, which is completely fine. The bounce, it is. Okay, let's see. We have many people in the middle, fellas. We truly have many people in the middle. Skill, what is your plan? Tell us, what do you think? Well, I have an answer to your all questions to everything what you want to know. Skill, how you are going to annoy enemies. I will show you a magical play, fellas, when enemy forces can go and F themselves, especially the ones which is sitting in the balcony right there. Skill, you will take one for the team, I don't care. Look. This is very, very important play by us, okay? It is super important play by us. So we are crossing like this. We are taking this position over there. And all bushwankers, which is playing around this area, they are doomed. They are effed. Now look. You might think, but Skill, this kind of gameplay is not that super duper hyper turbo good. Wrong. Why so? Now, pay attention at this, fellas. We are going to spot the 260 and the chieftain for remaining of the battle. They are going to cry for 3 days, 3 nights, because they are going to get proxy spotted in this balcony. In a way, is becoming useless, because they simply cannot do anything. If they are peeking like this, we have people which is already either pre-aimed over there or either about to shoot those guys over there, right? This is the main plan, this is the main thing for us. So, all we need to do right now is to chill, to relax, and take it easy. Meanwhile, what is happening over there? The chieftain is joining us, but the chieftain is not going over there. He will go pir-pir-pir-pir-pir like this, right? The most important thing for him is going to be to deal with this E100, which is completely understandable. And for us, it is Armageddon. Remember the joke which I said before? Arta save, haha. Yes, in this battle, fellas, there is no chance we can be Arta safe whatsoever. So I am just simply chilling and I'm waiting and I'm sacrificing my hit points right there, right? I know what is happening. I completely understand I'm getting bombed by the Arta which is around this area right there. But once again, not much what I can do about this. Only one thing how we can play this battle, we can be actually patient and simply wait until the enemies will mess up or to do something very, very silly, right? Now, obviously, if the 260 is trying to make a bit of pressure over there immediately, he is taking one for the team and it's not even debatable, it's not questionable, it's just how it is. This is why this position is so damn powerful and that's why you need to take it either with a medium tank or either with a light tank or either with a heavy, when you do not have better things to do. Now look, playing over there in the middle wouldn't be as great option for us. Why am I saying so? Because it just simply wouldn't work. There is no one to fight with, and I assume enemy team have some tank destroyers which is sitting around this area. So once again, just wait for it, hold it, and we will wait for our time to shine, right? Whenever enemies will do something very, very silly. This is the most important thing. And even though we had, remember fellas, the first battle, we got like 8,000 combined in the first 4 minutes. Now we have 400 combined in the first 4 minutes. And you know what? I am feeling good with it. I am feeling extremely good with it, because this elimination from this super duper hyper turbo epic position over there, it is good for us. I can promise you that, fellas. It is very, very, very good for us, and it is good for our team. So hold it, wait it, and we'll see how the things, what the things will bring for us, right? As you can see, this 260 is crying in the corner right here because he got outspotted by the full hit points, and by default, just by playing the balcony, he is going to get eliminated from the game. I know it sounds very, very weird and it sounds quite bad, at least for him, but this is how the things is working in this battle, my lovely friends. This is exactly what we are doing and this is our plan. Now speaking about our plan, if you would pay attention over there, you would notice almighty Jack Pizda sitting around this area, and Jack Pizda is dead. Good, beautiful. This is exactly what I want to see next. Now look, how about if we would check this corner, who is living over there? Maybe we can punish someone. What do you think? There is only one way how we can figure out the things. We are checking this out and we have a bloody pixel. Too bad I managed to miss it, that's completely fine. TVP is going super turbo, hyper turbo aggressively, and luckily he changed his mind. For him to change his mind right here, it is a great victory for us boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Because now we can start side scrapping against this guy and he is just simply throwing his ammunition for literally nothing. And we are spotting him. And now when he's on the reload, he's dead. This is exactly what we wanted to do and this is exactly what we have done right here. Speaking about the things, as you can see, we are trying to search for opportunities to punish this guy and he's dead. Now look. Now you might think, but skill, this is not victory. Oh boys, you would be surprised. Now look. What we are doing, we are going even more up right here and we will proxy spot this Fava until he will forget his until he will forget his name, until he will say This is exactly what we are looking for, okay? This is our main mission right here, just to annoy this mother trucker. Also, speaking about the other things, there is a big chance that Chieftain is going for the budget over there. So what I need to do, I need to check out, maybe someone is crossing like this. Because if someone is going right there, we are going to be able to see them, right? Once again, checking the Fava, is he still over there? He is chilling or not really? And the answer is no. He, by the looks of it, he is not over there. That's good. That's good, fellas. We have all time in the world of tanks. And this is how do I play this shitty ass map. Patience is the most, I repeat, patience is the most important part of this map. If you will be impatient for millisecond, you will cry in the corner and you will get completely destroyed and it's going to be end of the game for you. So keep this in mind. Once again, look at the same Fava. He's thinking about making a bit of pressure over there. And you know what? Fava is sitting in the deep shithole and Fava just shot. Did you hear that big bada boom? Because I did. So skill, what is the plan now? I am going to load the high explosive ammunition for one particular purpose, which is to track him. And after that, we are going to flank him. Are you ready? Ready for this? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, into the track. And you know what? It is completely fine. You might think, skill, you are dead. No, I'm not. Nope, I'm not dead. I am feeling very, very good. In fact, I am feeling like a fresh pickle right here. And now we are going to bank him like there is no tomorrow. He will try to push me down off the hill, which is completely understandable, but he is not going to do that in time. Why so? Because I said so. That's it, he's dead meat. Finito, GG, game over. Who is the person which is winning the battle? Skillies! Obviously, with all respect, fellas, enemy team played as well as we could, but our team played better. Our team was so much more patient, and you can say whatever you want. This endgame thing to push on the Death Star was good, and to spot the people which is playing in the balcony was even better. Here you go. Second battle was a fail. The third battle over there was glorious. It was amazing. It was very, very good. And here we go. That's what we have, fellas. We have like 5,000 combined. Okay, 4,700 combined. And we deserved every single thing what we got right there. That was a glorious performance. Now, remember, fellas, what did I said about the what this map is created for? Arta, Arta, Arta. Three Artas, top five, fellas. This is just how it goes. This is how this... this map is working. This is one of the best maps for Arta because there is nowhere to hide. Anyways, in the end of the day, we managed to get 3,300 damage and 1,600 assisting damage, actually 1,700 assisting damage, which is bringing us to 5,000 combined. This is exactly what we was aiming for. And you know what? With all respect, I am feeling happy. The second battle, I thought I am going to have more support, but I was risking for the biscuit. And in the end of the day, I got slaughtered, but that's okay. Great performance. Great battles, skill is happy, and I hope you are happy too. So the main question, 140 needs to get buffed or not? Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Skill is out. Bye bye.